and probably not the most practical question, but all the pieces are certainly things that are practical, and so it's good practice for us. Looks like they want me to find the inverse of F, the inverse of G. Looks like we're going to do some composition. We're going to plug some stuff into each other. And that's not going to be in terms of X. We're actually going to plug the 1 in at the end, so we just get a numerical answer. Okay. So to even do this, I need to know the inverse of F and G. So if F is 1 8 x minus 3, switch x and y, solve for y, let's keep up with their notation correctly. So there's the inverse of F. Let's see, I'm going to need that. Also going to need the inverse of G. So G is x cubed. Switching the input and the output would look like that. Solving the output would be cube root on this side. So cube root on this side. That is the inverse of G, so I should call it such. Keep up with everything. Now, I've got these two pieces, I can worry about this composition. So it's not the letter O, it's not multiplication, it's not dot product. Very, very small difference in time, completely different difference in meaning. So which one am I plugging into which? The one on the right is always the inner function, the one on the left is always the outer function. So I should be plugging this into this. So instead of 8x plus 24, I get 8 cube root of x plus 24. Place of x, I replace it with the inverse of g. Now, if you didn't have anything out here, if you didn't have this one here, that would imply that they want you to keep your answer in terms of x and you would be done. Well, since they put a 1 here, that means they actually want you to plug 1 in for x and evaluate, come up with the number. So the cube root of 1 is 1 times that by 8, add it to 24, and so they should be coming up with 32 as an answer. Again, I can't think of any application where you would need to find two inverses, plug them into each other, and plug them one. But I can think of a million applications where inverse is important, composition is important, and evaluating is important. So if you can really, really understand those things and you can do those things, this question shouldn't be any different. Alright. Set okay for 79. Anybody else want to ask about 79? What's the clarification on 79? Okay, so I don't know what your next question is, but it seems like you guys were asking both about 79 and 83, and they're both in that same set of numbers. There's 81, one of the questions assigned. Okay, so if you struggle with both of those just because 81 is not your homework, probably a good idea to go ahead and do it, pick an 81 over the others because it's odd and you can check your book. So if you really want to go to from 79 to 83, 81 should be a problem. I'm adding it to your homework assignment. But if you need some extra practice, that